once solid turns to liquid. It stands for the letter M. Be sure you are calculating with grams. Along with mass, the change of temperature is delta T, hot or cold. And finally, it's mononational. If delta T is negative, that means the substance was cooling down. Cause when you're thermal, you're either elbow or outside. You just gotta feel it. And when you're thermal, MOP shows activation energy. Positive, negative, and this comes from Q equals MC delta T. At thermo. Specific heat plays a role too. Even letter C makes this true. Lower C than water in hand, and it proves to have a higher C. Hydrogen bonding takes more energy, increases the C energy to raise the 10 by 1 degree Celsius of 1 gram of substance. That is part of calorimetry. Cause when you're thermal, you're either elbow or axle. Just gotta feel it. And when you're thermal, enthalpy shows activation energy. Delta H signifies this, for it can be used in multiple equations. This is log in free energy. Endothermic means energy absorbed. Exothermic is when the energy is released. To touch, it's the opposite. Real life chemical reactions do happen on a day-to-day basis. This melted cube is endo. Taking in heat as when you're thermal, you're either endo or exo. You just gotta feel it. And when you're thermal, and the shows activation energy. Finding the Q value is the goal, and it is measured in joules of energy. This is what activation energy is. Thanks for filming it and then